Morning, dear students. In the last class, we started the crystallization. In the crystallization, what is the crystallization? Large crystals of fluid substance can be formed from their solutions is called crystallization. So, crystallization is an example of a physical change. It is not a chemical change. Crystallization is an example of physical change. Okay. So, crystallization we can easily understand by the activity. Crystallization. Okay, what is the crystallization activity? Now, in the activity, in the crystallization method, in this activity, we have to use only dilute sulfuric acid. Be careful while boiling water. Okay, so here in this activity, we have to use the dilute sulfuric acid. What is the activity? First, in this activity, we have to take the 1 cup of water in a beaker and add a few drops of dilute sulfuric acid. First, we have to take the 1 cup full of water in a beaker and add a few drops of dilute sulfuric acid. First, we have to take in the water and in that we can add the few drops of dilute sulfuric acid and heat the water. After that, heat the water. When it starts boiling, add copper sulfate powder slowly while stirring continuously. Continue adding copper sulfate powder till no more powder can be dissolved. That means, first we have to take the cup full of water in a beaker, add a few drops of sulfuric acid, dilute sulfuric acid, heat the water. When it starts the boiling, add copper sulfate powder slowly while stirring continuously. Continue adding copper sulfate powder till no more powder can be dissolved. We can add the copper sulfate powder. After that, filter the solution, allow it to cool. Do not disturb the solution when it is cooling. When it is cooling, you don't disturb the solution. Look at the solution after some time. Can you see the crystals of copper sulfate? Okay, if we leave it the if we undisturb the beaker, after some time we can observe that copper sulfate crystals. For suppose if it is not form the copper sulfate crystals, means wait for some more time, then it will be form the copper sulfate crystals. Now, in this activity, first take a cup full of water in a beaker and add a few drops of which one we can add and add a few drops of which chemical? Few drops of dilute sulfuric acid. Heat the water. When it starts boiling, add copper sulfate powder. Add copper sulfate powder slowly. While stirring continuously. While stirring continuously. Continue adding copper sulfate powder. Continue adding copper sulfate powder till no more powder can be dissolved. Till no more powder can be dissolved. Filter the solution, allow it to cool. Filter the solution and allow it to cool. Do not disturb the solution when it is cooling. Okay, do not disturb the solution when it is cooling. And look at the solution after some time. After some time, once you have to watch the solution. What you can observe? Can you see the crystals of copper sulfate? Look at the solution after some time. Then we can see the crystals of copper sulfate. If not, wait for some more time. If it is not form the crystals of copper sulfate, means we can wait for some more time. Okay, so this is about the crystallization, copper sulfate crystallization, crystals of copper sulfate. I will send you the diagram how it will be formed. It is blue color. Okay, now you have to learn about the physical and chemical changes in this chapter and try to identify changes that you observe around you as a physical or chemical changes. In our surroundings, some of the physical changes is there, some of the chemical changes is there. So we can try to identify which is a physical change, which is a chemical change. For suppose cutting of wood, if we cut the wood, means again it will be grow. For suppose tree is cut, means it will be grow. That is a reversible. Reversible changes are physical change. Irreversible changes are chemical change. Okay, in this chapter, we learned about the chemical change and chemical reactions and crystallization and galvanization and physical change and rusting. So in this chapter, we are discussed about the chemical change, chemical reaction, crystallization, galvanization, physical change and rusting. Okay, generally changes two types. One is a physical change and chemical change. Physical changes are changes in physical properties of substance. Physical change means it will be changed the physical properties of the substance, and no new substances are formed in these changes. These changes, it is a reversible. Okay, in chemical changes, new substances are produced. Some substances can be obtained in pure state form from their solutions by crystallization. Okay, this is about the changes around us. So now chapter finished. Okay, thank you.